Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Manisha Gaur and today I will discuss what is fabric and how it is made. You all have been wearing clothes since your childhood. I am wearing clothes and you all must be wearing clothes. So have you ever wondered how the fabric or the cloth that we wear every day has been made? What are the things that are required to make a fabric? What are the raw materials required to make a cloth, a fabric? We see different clothes of different colors, of different material. So what is the science behind fabric construction? We will discuss all these things today in detail in this lesson. So let's begin with what is fabric. As you can see in the picture, fabric is nothing. It's just a piece of cloth. Like we assemble a lot of piece of cloth to make one fabric that we wear, like you wear shirt, you wear pant, suit, sari, yes, you wear skirt, you wear shirt, you wear knicker and all. All these things are nothing but a piece of cloth assembled into a particular article that we use as a cloth or a fabric. The shirt is nothing but an assemblage of clothes or the designing of cloth in such a manner that it looks like a shirt to you, so that you can wear it. They can be different colors, they can be different styles, you know, they can be different methods, different techniques of making a fabric. Because one shirt can be a plain white, the other shirt can be a printed with all the colors, with different colors, or it can be a striped shirt as well. So how these kind of varieties are put in into a fabric? So fabric is any piece of cloth that we use. So there are various techniques and methods for doing so, and we will discuss each one of them in detail. Fibers and yarns are converted into fabric for apparel and household textiles. For apparel clothing, you have your shirt, your pant, your suit, your sari, skirt, blouses and other things. For household textiles also, we use fabric, like for upholstery, like your sofa cover, you have curtain, you have dusting cloth at house. So all these forms a household textile for which we use a fabric. We incorporate some sort of technique into it, or we incorporate some sort of differentiation into the construction method itself, by which we convert one fabric into a shirt and another fabric into a curtain. So this is all about how you are constructing a particular article out of your given fabric. So now we will discuss about the techniques and the construction techniques for making fabric. So there can be weaving, knitting, non-woven construction technique, braiding, net and laces. Now we will discuss each one of them in detail. Let's first discuss about weaving. Weaving is most commonly used method of fabric construction. Most of the clothes that are available in the market are done by weaving process. How the chatai is being made, or normal jute floor mat that you have at your house. If you see it closely, then you will see there are two sets of longitudinal and vertical, two sets of lines that are going parallel to each other. Two sets of yarn that intersect at right angle. Like one is going vertical and other is going horizontal. So when they intersect each other at the right angle, then the pattern that is being made out of this kind of arrangement is called as weaving. Now we will discuss about knitting. You must have worn at your childhood days, or maybe even today, a sweater or some sort of a woolen garment that is being knitted by your mother or your grandmother. So what is the process of knitting? How such kind of an article is being built by some technique that you use by interlooping one yarn into the another, and you will get a beautiful article made out of it. So knitting is a process wherein one ball of yarn which is interlooped to make a fabric. And you must have observed that this kind of arrangement increases the elasticity, that is the power of stretchability of the fiber or the fabric that is being made out of it. And it's not very difficult to, you know, care and maintain that particular article. You just have to wear it at one season, and while you are moving towards another season, you just need to, you know, wash it or dry clean it, and then you have to just pack it. You don't have to, you know, every day clean it and do certain kind of another maintenance techniques to it. Now we will discuss about non-woven fabric. So learners, till so far we have discussed about two techniques. One is weaving and the another is knitting. Now apart from these two methods, there is one more method of constructing a fabric, which is known as non-woven method, where the fabrics are directly made from fibers without weaving or knitting. So how the fiber is how the fabric is being made by using this kind of method? In this case, fibers are held together by mechanical forces like gum or heat, and then they are being pressed to form a sheet of cloth that we use as a non-woven fabric, and it's widely available in the market. Now we will discuss about braided fabrics. You must have seen, or your mother must have braided your hair, you know, to make into a braided kind of an hairstyle, where we have three layers or three sets of yarn, and then we interwoven it into a braided format. As you can see in the picture also, it must click in your mind also, like we have braided fabrics that are created in a fashion that is similar to braiding of hair. And braided fabrics are mostly used for making shoelaces, belts, and other articles also, like you can make your coasters also by braiding article. By braiding the fabric, you can make your coasters, you can make your doormats, you can make the whole carpet of your house also by this process of braiding. You must have seen like jute bags or jute robes, they are also being made by the kind of braiding that they use. Now we will discuss about net. Net is nothing, it's an open mesh fabric with geometrical shape. Yarn can be knotted at the point of intersection. There is a net you must have seen at the tabletop. Tabletop cover is mainly of net. You can have knit sari, which has, you know, small open pores, and the open mesh fabric construction is there, where there is an interlooping at the point of intersection of the yarns, and then it make into a proper open mesh like structure, which is very plain and it's very lightweight and it is like porous, so because it has small holes. Now we will discuss about laces. So laces are crisscross to create an intricate design. You must have seen a layer of laces around your blouse, around your skirt, or when you have some, you know, decorative or some sort of an party wear dresses, you must have seen at the border there is a very decorative kind of lacing that runs throughout the length of the fabric. So that is lace. Yarns may be interloop, interlace, or knotted to give a open mesh structure. So if you touch that lace singly, you know, without the attached fabric, you can see that it is an open mesh structure. And the yarns in that pattern are interlope, they are interlaced, or they are knotted to give a very, you know, beautiful intricate design into it. Beautiful decorative designs can be created through lace making. As you can see in this picture, we can see that the, you know, combination and individual yarns are interlooped, they are interlaced into one another to form this, you know, continuous beautiful pattern. And it can be used for making some sort of a shape also, like you can make into a leaf motif, you can make into a flower motif, you can make into a simple, you know, braided motif also. So various kind of motifs can be created by interlacing and interlooping the yarns together. And if you can see it closely, this is an open mesh structure. Now we will discuss the process of weaving. So as we have already discussed in our earlier discussion, that weaving is nothing, it's just when two sets of yarns are interlaced at right angle to one another. As you can see in this picture also, that there are like two sets of yarn. One is vertical yarns, you know, the black ones, and the yarns that are intersecting it at the crosswise direction, that is the yellow one, are the horizontal yarn, or the yarns that are running parallel to the other yellow yarn. So when these two sets of yarns intersect each other at right angle, then this kind of arrangement or this kind of pattern and the sequence that they form is called as weaving. Now let's discuss about the process of weaving. So as we have already discussed that the process of weaving follows the process that a chatai maker will follow for making a beautiful chatai. So when the chatai is made, some ropes are held parallel to one another on a one frame. So they held one frame and they have like sets of yarns on one side, that is the vertical side, and then they intersected with the another sets of yarn that goes crosswise, you know, horizontally, and they have like sequence of parallel yarns to make a beautiful sequence out of it. In the process of weaving, there are certain terminologies and or there are certain definitions that we need to understand and learn. Like we have just discussed that there are two sets of yarn, so there must be some name for each set of yarn also. So now we are discussing what these sets of yarn and what kind of pattern that they make is being called. So first is warp yarn. Yarns that run along the length of the fabrics or that is parallel to the selvage. We will discuss what is selvage in the later discussion. So let's focus on what is warp. Yarns that run along the length of the fabric or parallel to the selvage is called the warp yarn, or they are also called as ends. Now let's discuss about the weft yarn. So the warp yarn are the lengthwise and the weft yarn are interlaced with warp in a crosswise direction to make a fabric. Like you can see this, this is a process in which you can see the warp yarn, that is, you know, longitudinal ones or the perpendicular ones, and you can see the weft yarn, that is the, you know, the horizontal one. So when these two kind of yarns interlace one another at right angles, so the kind of sequence that we get is the pattern. So selvage, as you have just noticed that warp yarn run parallel to the end of the selvage. So what is selvage? Selvage is two long finish edges along the length of the fabric is called as selvage. The main purpose of selvage is to give strength to the fabric, and the warp yarns run parallel to the selvage. So if you get a cloth, then you can identify what are the warp yarns and what are the weft yarn by looking or finding the selvage. Once you have found the selvage line, you can very easily detect what are the warp yarns and what are the weft yarns, because the warp yarns are the yarns that run perpendicular or parallel to the selvage, and weft yarns are the crosswise yarn that are horizontal or that interlace warp yarns at the right angle. So you can see in this picture also, warp yarns are the one that are perpendicular and that run parallel to the selvage, and the weft yarns are the one that are that run crosswise or they that are horizontal to the warp yarn and they interlace warp yarn at the right angle. Now what is the thread count? Thread count refers to the total number of warp and weft yarn per square inch of a woven fabric. Now the basic purpose of knowing a thread count is to know the quality and the durability of the fabric. Like cotton fabric has a very high thread count, because of which it is very durable and its quality also stands well among other fabric. Now we can see in this picture in detail the sequence or the pattern that is being formed by the weaving process. So you can see the weft yarn here, you can see the warp yarn, and you can also see the selvage here. So you can see the loops that run parallel to the warp yarn, and the loops that you can see that run throughout the length of the fabric. So if you can see or if you can find such kind of a loop kind of sequence towards the one edge, towards the end or towards the one edge of your fabric, you can find the selvage. And once you have find the selvage, it's very easy for you to identify which is the warp yarn and which is the weft yarn. So I repeat, warp yarns are the ones that run lengthwise or parallel to the direction of selvage, or the yarns that run lengthwise or perpendicular to the weft yarn are the warp yarn. Weft yarn are the one that run crosswise to the warp yarn, or that lie horizontal in comparison to the warp yarn, and the warp yarn and the weft yarn interlace one another at right angle, and this kind of arrangement continue further to form a further sequence that is called as a woven fabric. So the fabric that is made out of the process of weaving is called as a woven fabric. So this is a procedure by which we will get the fabric that we use in making many articles. Now we will discuss what are the types of weaves. There are like different types of weaves by which we will get n number of different arrangement and sequences in the fabric that we have in the market. So like cotton is like one fabric, but there are n number of arrangement in the weaves and in the weaving process that we use by which we make a different kind of, you know, fabric out of it by just doing a little changes into the process. Like we have mulberry cotton, like we have jean cotton and other cotton. So we will see in detail. So now we will discuss first type of weave, that is a plain weave. It is the simplest weave and it is very inexpensive to produce. So you can understand by this definition that this kind of weave is highly available, and most of the fabric that are available in the market are made out of this plain weave. And this plain weave can be of two types. One is rib weave and the another is basket weave. So let's see what are rib weave and basket weave. Okay, so we can see here what are the types of weaves we have just discussed. We can see in the picture the rib weave and the basket weave. So rib weave, we can see that there are like certain interlooping at different intervals by which a sequence is being formed. And the basket weave is also the same process, like interlacing of one yarn over the another in such a sequence that is used for making a jute basket. So this kind of sequence is used for making a fabric also. Now we will discuss about twill weave. Now this is a basic weave and it has a clear diagonal line on the face of the fabric. And because of this property, this kind of twill weave is widely being used for making n number of articles. Like you have your jean fabric, you have your khadi twill weave fabric. So all these fabric are being used by making a twill weave. And it is, you know, thick also, and its durability is also very good of the fabric that is being made by the twill weave. Now let us discuss satin weave. You must have seen a very, you know, shiny surface article that we wear when we are going for some party and some other thing. What kind of material is it? It is a satin weave. So you must have, some sort of household article also that you use for decoration at your household also that is being made up of satin. It is a very shiny surface. It gives a very shiny look. So this basic weave has a beautiful shiny surface because of long floats on the surface of the fabric. You can see in the picture also, the surface looks very shiny and it's very sheen. It gives a very sheen finish. Next process of making fabric, that is knitting. So as we have just discussed in our earlier discussion also, knitting is the interlooping of one yarn over the another to make a beautiful pattern which stands for its elasticity and easy care properties. Knitting is making of cloth with the help of needles to create a series of interlocking loops with a single yarn. You can see in this picture also that by using a needle, a certain kind of interlocking loops are being formed, which is being highlighted in the picture itself. By using a single yarn, like there is a ball of yarn, and by using an interlooping only the single yarn, we create a beautiful sequence that we use for our fabric construction. So in this process as well, like we have in weaving, we have warp and weft yarn. In knitting, we have courses and wheels. So courses are series of successive loops lying in crosswise direction, that is on horizontal pattern, and veils are the lengthwise or vertical columns of loops. So vertical and horizontal, that is veils and cores, are interloop into one another to form a knitted garment. Now let's discuss what is the difference between a weaving and knitting. So these are the two main process of construction of fabric that are widely being used, and they are most popular and most appreciated one. So what is the difference? when we have to use a weaving process and when we have to use a knitting process, and what are the properties of woven article and the knitted article. So weaving and knitting are the popular methods of fabric making, and depending upon the end use and properties, either of them can be chosen. So you can see the process of weaving and knitting here. In the weaving process, two sets of yarns are used, but they are interlaced at right angle so that a, you know, intermesh kind of sequence is formed. While in knitting, you use single kind of an yarn, but you interloop it in such a way that a beautiful kind of interlooping sequence can be made. In this, the crosswise are called courses and the lengthwise are called veils. Whereas in weaving, the crosswise are called weft yarn and the lengthwise are called wove yarns. So let's discuss the properties of weaving and knitting. So if we consider the number of yarns that are there for the weaving and the knitting, then we can see that in weaving, two sets of yarns are interlaced at right angle, as we have just discussed, to form a beautiful pattern like wove and weft yarns. Whereas in knitting, one set of yarn is interlooped with each other at right angle to form a certain kind of a sequence. And in this, courses and veils are there. So there is a single yarn that is interlooped into itself, by which the lengthwise is called the courses and the crosswise is called the veils. Now we will discuss another property, that is what kind of equipment is used for weaving process and the knitting process. So for weaving, a loom, or it can be a hand loom or the automatic loom is used. As you can see in the picture also, that there it's a kind of an apparatus that is called as a loom, in which one side warp yarns are being tied up and the another side the weft yarn that goes crosswise to the already tied warp yarns, so that the sequence can be formed. So for weaving, we can have hand loom or the automatic loom, and for knitting, only needles that we require. Needles could be hand knitting or machine knitting. So needles either could be used by, you know, you do the hand knitting kind of a thing, so by which you have the needles and you can just hand knit it, or this can be done through the help of the machine also, that makes it machine knitting. Now let's discuss what kind of fabric is formed by the process of weaving and the knitting. So when you have used weaving, then you will get a very firm, very smooth and stable fabric. You know, that can be stiff, that can be soft, it can hold its durability and strength also, and it is it has a stiffness all along the height. And when we discuss about the knitting, so by knitting we will get wrinkle resistant, stretchable, limp and fit the body kind of a fabric. Like you have your woolen garments that just fit your body, it have a that limp, like, you know, the bouncy kind of an effect also. It's wrinkle resistance also, and it can be easily stretchable. It can have a very good elasticity because of the sequence that is being used in its construction. Going further, let's discuss about the care and maintenance of the article that are being made by the weaving and the knitting. So for the weaving, we need to follow proper washing and ironing before its reuse. Once you have used a woven fabric, you need to wash it and you need to iron it before you can reuse or you can further use it again. While in case of knitting, you don't require to iron it because it retains its shape as it's the original one. So you don't need to iron it further, and you just need to dry flat on the ground. You don't need any kind of a special arrangement for it. So what are the designs, you know, what designs can you create by using these two kind of methods? So weaving can be created by using different yarns of different colors and types. So, you know, different kinds of pattern can be made by using or by playing with the yarns that you use for making a woven fabric, or the colors or the type of the yarns that you use. Like you can make a cotton silk fabric out of it by using cotton and silk yarns. You know, you can have silk yarn as your perpendicular, or the warp yarns can be a silk one, and then you interlace the cotton yarn crosswise, that is your weft yarn, so that you can make a cotton silk article out of it. So you can just play around with it. While in case of a knitted garment can be used by creating, you know, various knitting yarns, and it can be made by changing the stitches or the color. So you can have different stitches. By changing the stitches or the yarn color, you can make different sequins and different patterns. So now we discuss about the final outcome or the final property of every article for which all these properties are combined together, that is the use of the article. So the article made up of weaving process can be used in making apparels, upholstery, curtains, draperies, table linen, bed linen, and likewise many other garments. And the knitted garment can be used for making undergarment, hosiery, sweaters, t-shirt, you have stockings, you have socks, and you have many more things that you can make out of a knitted garment, or the process of knitting can be further enhanced to incorporate various designs and can be made into a more beautiful patterns and sequins. So I hope, learners, you have understood now the process of fabric construction, that is weaving and knitting, braiding, non-woven fabric, laces, you know, net, and many other things that we have discussed. The process of weaving, that includes the warp yarn, weft yarn, the selvage, and in the knitting that we have courses and veils, that the process of weaving that you have lengthwise and the crosswise, that you interlace into one another at right angle and you make a sequence out of it, that is your process of weaving. And in case of a knitting yarn, you have a single ball of yarn and you interloop it in such a manner that it creates a beautiful sequence, or that is an interloop kind of a structure. So you have courses and veils in that. And further on, you have various kind of weaves like rib weave, twill weave, basket weave, by which you can make a different kinds of patterns. And now we have also discussed about the properties of weaving and knitting, that which is better in which case and where the usage of which article is most preferable one. So I hope you have understood it very clearly. Thank you so much.